pickaninny. You're going to kill yourself flying like that. Yes, you are.
Wendy?
You bet. I thought you was deep, Pops.
I'm sorry. I didn't hear you speak.
Didn't say nothing.
Didn't you?
Mr. David Burke.
607, sir. Excuse me.
Floor, mister?
Six.
You hear that wind? Man, I'm gonna get myself grounded out of the Air Force. That's what I'm gonna do. Ain't gonna fly this kind of crate anymore. Can you blame me?
Right on time, Slater. Right on time.
All right there, Yuli.
Come in, come in.
Here, let me help you off with your things.
You're doing such a big old dog in New York.
I never had a wife.
Right on the button. That's what I'm looking for, Slater. Someone serious with a head for business. All right, here. Come on, over here. Here, up. Whiskey?
I don't mind.
Straighter with water.
With water.
I got ice. You want ice?
No, just water.
Make yourself comfortable, Slater. We got to talk. Lack of view?
You got a whole heap of it.
I used to be able to afford a little space inside, too. But we call this dump home, don't we, old boy?
Not bad.
Well, here's to our mutual benefit. May it be considerable.
I guess you know all you have to know about me, Slater.
I know something.
All right, you tell me what you know. Go on.
You said you wanted to talk to me. Since we knew a few people in common, I naturally wanted to come and find out.
I mean the dirt.
I know you were on the police force. You had a session with the state crime committee, and you got a year for contempt.
Because I wouldn't talk. I was on the force 30 years. I had my own squad, and I knew everybody. Everybody was my friend until they needed a patsy. I know about you, Earl. Two stretches, one for assault with a deadly weapon, one for manslaughter. Every time you get a decent job, you
knock it off. So big about you, Burke. Come, you make so much noise. You've been sniffing around trying to find a hole in the fence just like everybody else. What makes you so big you can call me up to this dump and shoot off your mouth?
I got an idea, that's why, Slater. How would you like to pick up $50,000 all in small bills just for yourself? How would you? Hello. Johnny? No, when? Sure, that's fine. Well?
What would I have to do?
Just walk into a bank and take it.
Maybe you got me wrong, Bert. I never stole nothing in my life. Except maybe a watermelon when I was a boy on the farm.
I don't want a big Joe with more decorations than Dillinger. I want a safe thing. I want a man who needs some money to set himself up. I want a man with guts. I want a serious guy in trouble, and that's you, that's me, that's the both of us. This is a one-time job, one roll of the dice, and then we're through forever. Come on, Slater, what do you say?
To make it?
Always made it before.
Yeah, with my luck, Daddy, this could be it.
Maybe on the way down.
I'm walking down.
Back. Shut up, your mother. Johnny, come in, come in.
Hello, Daddy.
Spam. You'll get hair all over you. Take off. Here, let me help you.
Can't stay long, Dave.
Well, it takes some explaining. How about a drink?
No, thanks. You got the floor.
Here. He keeps shedding. All right there, come on, get up there. Those blue coats.
That's all right, don't worry about it.
Oh, you don't look like I could sell anything to you. You look like you have it all right now.
Come on, fill me in, Dave.
You're in debacle for too much dough.
Now tell me something I don't know.
You owe him about $6,000, right?
Wrong. 7.5.
It was 6 last week.
Well, the horses are still running and I'm still losing.
And Baco's willing to wait?
What's the pitch, Dave?
I know how you can pay it off.
I know what's coming next. The fix is in. It's a sure thing, right?
Well, now wait a minute.
No thanks, baby boy. I'll get out of the drain on my own.
You're crazy.
All right, so I'm crazy.
You're counting your fingers and toes. I'm talking about 5-0-0-0-0.
I'll take that drink. Straight.
Just tell me one thing, Johnny. How come Baco hasn't knocked your teeth in for not paying off?
Because I've paid him $100 a week interest.
Well, that can't leave you much.
Just my teeth.
You ever gonna pay it off?
And if we're out the streak, no use stopping now. I'm way past the life ropes and praying for a miracle. What do you mean, $50,000?
Just what I said. $50,000 to $75,000, like that. All in small bills.
You need Johnny Ingram? I'm just a bone pick in a four-man graveyard.
It's a bank job.
Are we social climbing, David?
This is easy money.
Man, you're drifting.
I'm serious.
That's not your line, Dave. That's the firing squad. That's for junkies and joy boys. We're people.
Okay. What's my line?
I'll forget you asked me.
You don't even want to hear?
I did all my dreaming on my mother's knee.
All right, forget it. Forget it. You riding?
Downtown.
I'll ride along with you.
A man like you thinking thoughts like that, Dave, you're in trouble.
I gotta get out of this trap. They've kicked my head in. What can I do?
Find a hobby, man, anything. They sure changed your color when they rehabilitated you at Sing Sing.
$50,000 can change it back. Here, come back here, you. Get back in here. You heard me. Mind this door. How are those two little women of yours?
The kid's fine. That ex-wife of mine. Man, she's worse than Baco. That alimony isn't there on the first, a lawyer's there on the second.
Thanks for the lift. If you change your mind, Johnny, I think I can get you the $7,500 right away to pay off Baco.
I got $500 on the nose of Lady K today. Can't lose forever.
You'd be surprised.
Just tell me, how come it isn't safe to walk in a park at night in a big city like this?
It's these wild kids.
Well, if it isn't the old clam himself.
This fresh air will kill you, Coco.
I know it, but it's pigeon time for the little king.
What's this, a press interview or something?
Go on, talk to the old man if you want to. He wants to do you a favor. What's the matter with this Davy Burke, he says? I want to pay him off.
Hi, Dave.
Hello, Baco.
Join me? Want me to open up something for you, Dave? Something in the operation. I told you, whenever you're ready.
You're outside the law.
A little inside, a little outside. More or less. Everything is a more or less. Just name it.
A fellow by the name of Ingram owes you.
Sure. A very entertaining boy at Canoy's place.
What time is it?
I'm on my way, stupid. Go back to sleep.
What time?
7:30.
Why so early?
Burke is waiting.
Earl? Can you trust this Burke?
Not like I can trust you, but enough.
Come here, you big clown.
Now you go back to sleep.
Let him wait.
I'm off to make my fortune.
Yeah? What kind of a fortune?
Just one of those fortunes. I told you about it. Burke got hold of some kind of concession.
Burke? Well, he's a friend of that Lefty Gowers, isn't he?
Yeah, he's the one who told Burke about me.
You knew Gowers in jail, didn't you?
No, at the Millionaires Club. Where else?
Earl, what does he want with you?
Tell you after I see the proposition.
You have to stay overnight? You just want to stay overnight?
Well, I have to see the concession.
You got enough money, sweetie?
Plenty.
How much is plenty?
About $15.
You better take some more.
Well, Burke is paying.
What do I care if he's paying? You take some more, and then if you feel like paying, you just pay.
You don't
have to take this deal if you don't like it. If this isn't what you want, you just don't take it. There's no hurry.
There is a hurry. I have to make it, Laura, and I have to make it now. It wasn't too bad when I was grabbing along by myself.
I know.
It was always too tough, too greedy, but now because of you.
No.
I have to make it on my own, Laura, because of you, and I have to make it any way I can.
No, you don't. Not just any way. And you mustn't even try.
I have to.
Earl, listen. I have you, right? You have me. What difference does it make where the money comes from?
They're not gonna junk me like an old car.
Earl.
Now, don't worry. If it isn't all right, I won't do it.
Miles up the Hudson. I've got it marked there. Milton. Watch the waiter. Over here. Here's the setup. That side door is the key to the whole job. The bank stays open Thursdays till 6. Most of the factories pay on Friday, so the bank is loaded with payroll cash and deposits from the stores. Every Thursday night, there's close to $200,000 in untraceable cash sitting in there. A half dozen clerks stick around for an hour, totaling up and straightening out the books. The assistant manager has a bad heart. Joe Foss, the guard, is about to retire, has glasses and arthritis. That's it. That colored waiter from the drugstore brings them coffee and sandwiches just after 6. The rest of the town's home and supper. You could take it with a water pistol. Well, what do you think?
There's just one thing wrong with it.
What?
You didn't say nothing about the third man being a nigger.
At night I tell you people, when that cold, cold sun goes down. At night I tell you people, when that cold, cold sun goes down. I not around. What's the matter, pretty baby? Tell me, what's your daddy done? Won't you tell me, pretty mama, what's your daddy done? You got to come and hold me for the morning sun.
Hi, baby, what's shaking? Baco wants to buy you a drink. And I want to buy you a shiny new car. Too bad about Lady Care.
Yeah, they bobbed her nose.
Believe me, pretty mama, it's not just me I know. Believe me, pretty mama, it's not just me I know. I just can't keep that jungle outside of my front door.
Well, at last, the invisible man.
I had a heart attack.
For a couple of horses.
Don't be like that, baby.
I don't care if you want to drop me, Johnny, but send back the key.
You said anything about dropping me.
Then you know where to find me. That's good. But it was better when you wanted it.
I told you, Baco has a message for you.
It's a long night, pretty boy. I'm not going anywhere.
Johnny. Maybe I should lend you a piece of iron.
Maybe.
I can let you have this juvenile delinquent.
I'm only playing with kids. Johnny, come in.
Hi, Gary.
Oh, hello, Johnny.
Can I see you, Ed?
Oh, why, sure. Want me to cut out?
No, not for me, Gary.
Johnny, what do you think of these?
Who are they for?
My oldest, her sweet 16th. Those are real cultured pearls.
16 already? Wow.
Yeah, they don't stand still like we do, Johnny. Well, what can I do for you?
Baco just blew in. Called me earlier today.
Oh? What do you own?
7500.
Come down for my money, Johnny.
I don't have it.
Maybe you're not looking hard enough. Maybe you think I'm a jerk and wait forever, eh?
Look, I lost again today. I've been losing steadily for a month. I just gotta break the streak I'm in, Baco. I can't let it knock me out.
Suit yourself. Just give the money to me by tomorrow night. All of it.
Suppose I can't.
There is no can't. I don't like the word can't. I say have it.
Can you bail me out, Ed?
I'm sorry, Johnny. I can't help you. Well, you already owe me a couple of thou anyway. Now, I asked you to stop with the horses. I remember I told you once and for all to stop.
I can't get it for you tomorrow.
You saying what to me?
Look, man, I'm telling you in front. I don't have it now, and I won't be able to get it by tomorrow. I'm not dancing with you, Moriarty.
You mean you come here with a gun? When I personally call you to talk to you? When I stretch you 6 months with a debt somebody else will be dead for, and you come here and pull a gun out of me?
The gun's in my pocket.
The gun's in my hand, that's what it is. I tell you, Ingram, I want you to know. Have that door at my place tomorrow night, or I collect it from you, or that ex-wife of yours, or your kid.
You'll do what?
Sorry, Johnny, drop that gun. See?
Tomorrow night, at 8, or I kill you and everything you own.
Well, it tells you in the good book, and they teach the same in school. Let a man get his hands on you, and he'll use you for a mule. My mama gave me warning, and now I know it's true. She said, all men are evil, and daddy, that's you. All men are evil.
All men are evil.
All men are evil.
She said, all men are evil.
All men are evil. All men are evil.
My mama told me.
My mama gave me warning, and now I know it's true. She said, all men are evil.
My
mama used to tell me, don't ever love no man, Johnny P. He'll use you and abuse you.
Don't ever love nobody.
I can't stand. My mama gave me warning, and now I know it's true. She said, all men are evil, and daddy, that's you. All men are evil.
Like someone slipped the leash or
my
something.
My mama gave me warning, and
all them cats is
callous. All men are evil.
That little boy is in big trouble.
That your last word?
I keep my mouth shut.
Think it over, Earl.
Nothing to think over. Just the idea of it makes me nervous. I wouldn't trust my own self on a deal like this with a colored boy.
Okay.
Hi. You're late.
I'm always afraid to wake up on this once a week Father's Day.
Johnny, what time will you get back?
Why?
I've got a PTA meeting tonight. Should I get a sitter?
You got your sitter.
Daddy!
Oh. How are you?
Fine.
All right, then, what do you see up there?
Park, the lake.
What else?
I see a merry-go-round.
Is that all?
I see a red balloon. I see people skating.
Give me a kiss. Sounds like Central Park today.
I'll get my things.
Oh, Mrs. Anker, this is Edie's father.
How do you do, Mr. Ingram?
Hello.
We're having a meeting of the PTA steering committee here. Some of my friends. This is Edie's father, Mr. Ingram.
How do you do, Mr. Ingram?
How do you do, Mr. Ingram?
Hello.
Hello, Mr. Ingram.
Well, Well, I hope you can steer your way out of it.
Very glad to meet you.
I'm ready, Daddy. Let's go. I'll get the elevator.
What did I ever see in you?
It's here, Daddy, it's here.
That?
Big idea.
Bucko's afraid you might blow town.
Look, you tell that Picklewood boss of yours that if he looks hard at my wife or baby, I'm blowing him a new one. I don't want to see you guys around here. You gum up the scenery.
We like it here.
I'm telling you to fade, or I'm turning you right in. Now, those cops.
That'll be the day.
Here, can I help you?
Can you tell me where I could find the zoo?
Oh, just go through that tunnel and follow the signs.
You stay right here, Edie. Daddy's got to make a phone call.
I'm staying. I'm eating.
And don't you budge.
I'll say that she stays here if you like.
Thank you, ma'am.
Mm-hmm. What's your name, little girl?
Edie.
Huh? Mr. Burke, please. Dave? Johnny. Yeah, I know you've been out. Listen, Dave, I'll take out that deal. No, wait. Listen, I need $7,500 right away to pay off Bucko. Yeah. All right, I'll call back in 15 minutes. Yeah, bye.
Hello, Bucko? Burke. Fine. That's what I'm calling about. Call those babies off.
I told you, Davey, I got a problem. It got a little rough. Now he has to make a deal. It was a public thing. He has to make a deal.
That's what I'm telling you. He's got a deal. I'm making it for him. I'll give you the dough in 2 weeks. He pulled a gun? Look, it can still be straightened out.